Welcome to your class. Today we're going to be starting off with some warm-ups for the hips, starting low to the mat, and then we're going to come up for a moon salutation, and then we're going to finish off our practice with some forward folds and some twists. So let's prepare ourselves for the practice by just doing a short little meditation just to connect into the body and the breath. So find the position that feels most comfortable for you. Make any adjustments to get a little bit more comfortable. Allow your hands just to relax wherever they happen to fall. And if it feels okay for you, go ahead and close your eyes or just take a soft gaze forward if you prefer that. And we're just going to take a moment just to feel the connection of our body onto the ground. Just noticing which parts of your body are connecting to the ground. And now from here, let's move it on to watching our breathing. We don't have to do anything special to the breathing. We're just going to watch it. You don't even have to change it. Just let it do whatever it wants to do. And next, we're going to bring our awareness to our body. Just see if you're noticing any kind of sensations or even your state of mind, like what's going on with you today. From there, we'll move on. So we're just going to keep that awareness and that attention all throughout the practice today into our connection to the ground, our breath, and how we're feeling in all of the postures. So let's go ahead and come on to hands and knees. And then you're going to take your knees nice and wide, let your toes come together. We're coming back for a child's pose. For just a moment here, just allow your hands to push down a little bit, to lift your chest a little. And then let your gaze go slightly forward and allow your shoulders to relax a little. And then from there, walk your hands forward about another hand distance. So keeping that little bit of an upward lift in the chest, start to pull your hips back on your exhale. Go ahead and pull back and even pull your navel up. And then once you're there, you can start to maybe even move your hands a little bit further forward. And we're just trying to get a little bit of length from our hips all the way up through the side of the body, through the armpits, all through the arms, reaching through the fingers. And if it feels comfortable for you, feel free to put your forehead on the ground. And then just connect back into how are you feeling here? Take another breath here. And then lift your gaze, come back up onto hands and knees with your hands reaching forward. Tuck your toes. Let's bring the knees in a little tiny bit, more like that tabletop. We're going to lift the knees just for a breath, just a few inches off the ground. Sometimes this posture is called bear. And then from there, go ahead on your exhale, shift back, let your navel pull your hips up and back as you go into your first variation of downward facing dog. We can take the feet nice and wide here on this first one. Feet as wide as the mat. Feel free to do that with your hands as well. And then just settle yourself in. Make any adjustments along the way. Let's breathe here. Let's take one more full breath. And then step your feet back into that hip distance position. And we'll shift forward back to that bear position. Shift your shoulders over your wrists, let your knees bend, and they're just barely off the ground. Nice and strong here. And then tap those knees down to the ground and untuck your toes. We're gonna go for a variation of downward facing dog lunge. Step your right foot forward to the outside of your right hand. You can come up onto your fingertips here, tuck your back toes, lift up your back knee, spin your back heel down, and now we're going to go and walk our hands over to the left side, and you're going to be stretching yourself into, if the top of your mat was 12 o'clock, you're going to be stretching towards 10 o'clock, reaching forward like we did with that child's pose, and then feel free to relax your head down. And also reaching back through the hips. And then on your next breath, lift your gaze forward and up and walk your hands back to that 12 o'clock position. And then the back toes turn forward. Nice and long through that back leg, front knee over the ankle. Tap your back knee down to the ground, and then place your right hand onto your right knee. Let your left hand come off to the side. Let's even pick up the right foot and turn it over to the right a bit. And then you can let your left hand go flat, and then you're going to find yourself into a twist, twisting towards that right side, looking up towards the ceiling, breathing. Another breath here, and then undoing your twist, gaze forward, walk your hands back to that 12 o'clock position, the right foot comes in, and then just take a pause here, and then maybe just readjust yourself, making sure you're feeling comfortable, and then we're going to shift the hips back just a little bit, and then we're going to shift them forward again, lifting up the heart, and you can have just your fingertips on the ground. You can also have your hands on your knee. Breathing here, a couple more breaths. And then those hands come back down to the ground. Pick up your back knee. And then we're just going to shift the hips forward again so that we're just gonna unroll over the tops of our toes. Place that left knee down. So now both of our knees are in a 90 position. And then both hands to the inside of that right foot. Maybe move your right foot over to the right a little. Take an inhale here. And then an exhale, bend your elbows. Breathe in here. You can keep that right knee and right shoulder connected to each other. And then on our next breath, straighten out your arms. And then you're gonna let that right foot move over, straight over to the right. So it's pointing straight over to the side. Now we'll just turn to the side to show you that visualization. All right, so from there, go ahead and come up with your torso. You're gonna lean your right elbow on your right knee. Let your left hand just rest on your leg there. And then you're just gonna pull the elbow up and just start to feel that length along that left side of the body. Breathing. And if it feels okay for you, you might be able to put your right hand down to the ground. And then we can reach that left arm straight up and over the ear. You can even kind of let it just drape over your left ear. One more breath. And then just go ahead and swoop your arms forward back to that 12 o'clock position. And then we'll bring the right knee next to the left knee. We're going to take it back to downward facing dog. So let's just for a moment go into bear, tuck your toes, push down into your hands, lift your knees just for a bit. Inhale here, exhale, shift back, pulling your navel up and back to help you go up and back. Find that downward facing dog. Feel free to take the feet wide if you want to. One more breath here. Let's shift forward back to that bear position. Shoulders move forward to the wrists and you start to bend your knees, just hovering just for a bit. And then you tap both your knees to the ground and untuck your toes. Going for the other side, step your left foot forward. Taking a breath here just to prepare. And then we're going for that down dog lunge to the side. So the top of your mat is at 12 o'clock. Tuck your back toe, pick up your back knee, spin your back heel down. Reaching your arms over to 2 o'clock position now. Reaching forward with the hands, reaching back with your hips. And then lifting your gaze, bring your hands back to the top of your mat. Turn your back toes forward. And just wiggle that back foot as far back as it can go and then tap that back knee to the ground. Hand to either side of your front foot. We're just gonna shift the hips back a little bit. And then as we go forward, the hips shift forward and down and your heart comes up. You can even put your hands on your knee if you like. But we have that forward moving action. One more breath. And then both hands down to the mat. Back toe is tucked. Pick up your back knee. And we're just going to shift the whole body forward so that we untuck the toes and we tap the back knee to the ground. So here we go, back into 90-90 position here. And you can let your left foot move a little over to the left, both hands to the inside of your left foot. And then feel free to bend your elbows here and bow. And then slowly start to straighten out your arms. And then you can walk your hands a little bit towards you. And then just move that left foot straight out to the left. And if you want to start with the left elbow on the left knee, let's go for that. Position yourself. You can just let your left palm face upwards. And then now that right elbow is just the hand and is just going to slide up the side of the body so the elbow is reaching up towards the sky. You got a bit of a half moon curve happening through your spine. And if you want to, you can stretch that right arm over. And you can make it so that it's curved over the side of your face. And one more breath here. And then just sweep your hands down to the mat and bring your left knee next to your right knee. We're going to go back to that bear and downward facing dog. Tuck your toes, inhale, prepare. Exhale, lift up the knees just a teeny bit for bear. Take another big inhale and then let your exhale lift your hips up and back. Let your navel pull you up and back. Find your downward facing dog. One more breath. And then from here, bring your big toes together, and you're going to step your right foot just to the middle of your mat, and then step your left foot next to it. Nice, generous bend into your knees for a forward fold here. And one more breath. And then we're going to slowly come up. Let your head be heavy, your arms be heavy. Chin stays tucked in. Slowly roll yourself all the way up. The knees stay bent, and they only straighten once your head comes all the way up. Slowly, slowly, shoulders start to roll back. And then the head comes up, and the knees straighten. Here we are in mountain pose. Just feeling the openness here. And then we're going to turn around to face the long end of the mat into the middle of the mat. So we're going to begin our moon salutation. Let's take our hands in front of the heart. And then just connect back into feeling your feet on the ground, noticing your breath. And notice how you're feeling right now. On your next breath, the arms come down. Inhale, reach them out and all the way up. Bring your hands together, your fingers together. And you can point your first two fingers up to the sky as you reach your arms all the way up here. So we're going to be going from side to side. Try to keep your gaze straight forward. Take an inhale here. Exhale, we're going over to the right side, anchoring down through the left. Take a couple more breaths here and only go to a place where you can really breathe well. The next breath will take us right back up to center. We'll call this center, feet straight ahead. And then go ahead and exhale over to your left. And then inhale straight back up again. Take your hands apart. Step your feet apart. Step, step. Let's go into a big, wide starfish position. And now we're going to prepare for triangle. Pick up your left heel. Spin it back halfway. Let your arms come to shoulder height. Pick up your right toes. Spin them straight ahead. Ready for triangle. Go ahead, reach forward to find your front hand anywhere on your leg, thigh, shin, or ankle, opening wide. And just notice the position that you normally go with your hand on your leg. Take another big breath here. And then we're going to take that back hand and sweep it backwards. And then forward to a lunge position. Both hands to the mat, both feet straight ahead. And then you're going to hop your back foot in just a few inches, and then go ahead and straighten out your front leg. If it doesn't completely straighten, that's okay. Take a couple more breaths. Go back to that lunge position. Bend your front knee, hop your back foot further back again, find your lunge. Couple more breaths. On the next breath, let your back knee tap down. Coming up with the torso, arms reach out and up, reaching up. Next breath, both of your hands sweep forward and to the inside of your right foot. Pick up your back knee. I'm just going to pivot that right foot slightly forward so it points to that left side corner of your mat. Spin your back heel down. You can even be up a little higher onto the fingertips here. And then we're going to walk ourselves to center, so both of the legs are straight. And then go ahead and pick up your left heel, spin it inwards towards the middle of the mat. So now both of your feet are at that diagonal line. And you're going to walk your hands to the inside of that left foot. And then go ahead and take it to facing the short end of your mat again. Tuck that right knee down. Here we go into a lunge position. We're going to tap that right knee down. Let's come on up. We're going to hold it up here. And then we're going to go back to that lunge position, lifting up your back knee. And then just hop your back foot forward just a tiny bit. And then go ahead and straighten up your front leg the best you can. It's okay if it has a slight bend. We're going to hop the back foot further back a little bit more, preparing for triangle. Remember where you placed your hand onto your leg? Let's go ahead and place the left hand where you normally would. We're coming into triangle from the bottom up. Sweep your right arm back and then let that reach you up with the torso. Right arm all the way up, breathing. And then really pressing your feet to connect to the ground, we're going to bring ourselves back up, arms up. Nice. Let's go into that starfish position. You're going to pivot both of your feet to face the long end of your back to center and arms up overhead, big starfish. Now we're going to come back to that standing mountain position. So you're going to step one foot in and then the other. Hands come up together, fingers point up, first two fingers, reach up. Inhale, exhale, let's go over to the right. And then back into center and over to the left. And center. And then slowly release your arms all the way down. Okay, we're going to do that again on the opposite side. So this time we'll be positioning to the left. Hands to the heart. Let's prepare, arms down, inhale, reach arms up, clasp them together, pointing upwards, leaning to your left side, facing forward, coming back to center, leaning to your right, and center. Step the feet apart, take the hands apart into starfish. And then preparing for triangle, the right heel picks up and spins back. The left toes pick up and spin forward, arms to shoulder height. Reach and find your triangle, front hand down, anywhere along the leg, right arm up. And then that right hand is going to sweep backwards and then forward, bending at that front knee for a lunge position. And then we're going to hop the back foot forward just a tiny bit. And then can you straighten out your front leg? Let's hop back to that lunge position again, holding here. Next breath, tap your back knee down to the ground. And then we're going to come all the way up. Reaching up. Next breath, sweep both of your hands forward and down to the inside of your left foot, picking up your back knee, just pivoting a little bit over towards the long side of your mat to take that angled position. And then shifting everything over to the center, feet facing forward. And then over to that right side, taking that angular position first. And then straight ahead for your lunge position. And then the back knee is going to come down to the ground. And then come all the way up with the torso, reach out and up. Next breath, back to a lunge position, back knee lifts, holding here. Hop your back foot in just a tiny bit so we can straighten out both the legs as much as you can. Bending your front knee again just a little bit. Hop your back foot back a little bit. Let's prepare for a triangle. Where do you like to place your right hand? Sweep your left arm back. Let that left arm reach you up as you straighten out your front leg. Next breath brings us all the way up. Really press into your feet to help lift you up. Arms to shoulder height, and then facing center, pivoting both of your feet to face center, reaching your arms up. Here we go, starfish. And now we're going to step the feet together and bring the hands together. So step, step, hands together, reaching upwards. Next breath, lean over to your left. And back to center, and over to your right, and center, and then arms slowly come down. Beautiful, hands to the heart. Take a moment. Just feeling the effects of the practice so far, and how that moon salute feels for you in your body at this time. And now, as we rolled up, we're going to come down to the mat. So you can turn to face the short end of your mat. We're just going to start to bow the head down. Let your shoulders come with you. Softness in your hips and your knees as you slowly can even let your hands slide down the legs. Head and arms are super heavy. Once the hands land to the ground, put one knee on the floor. And then the other. Take your knees wide, take your toes together. Let's go for that child's pose. Reaching forward, let your heart lift a little. Inhale, exhale, let your navel pull you back. Take a rest. The arms can be lifted or you can allow them to soften and relax. And then just slide your hands back towards your knees. And then keep your head down, chin tucked in, and slowly push yourself up. You can bring your knees together here. And then just take a moment here. And then go ahead and shift over to one side to bring your legs forward. We're going to take cobbler position. So let your knees be bent, feet on the floor, and then just let your knees drop out to the side. I'm going to just turn to face you. And then just try to find a place that just feels like quite natural and comfortable for you. That's going to decide how far your feet will be away from your body. And now we're going to make it just a little bit more active. Hands beside you. You're going to lift your hips up and shift your hips towards your feet. It may make your knees come up a little bit more. That's okay. We're going to push the feet towards each other and then feel as though the sides of your hips are moving in towards each other. So it's like you're trying to activate the muscles around the sides of your hips. And just breathe here. So it's an active stretch. We're making the muscles work by pushing the feet together, pushing the hips as though they could come together, but allowing your legs to move towards the ground as much as they want to. Take another breath here. And then relax that effort. And you can move yourself back away from your hips a little bit here. Take your hands to the inside of your knees, and you're just going to take your feet nice and wide. Just again to a comfortable position. We're not trying to go straight out to the side. We're trying to find a place where we can relax the legs, knees up and toes up. Let your hands come behind you for support. And then we're going to take the right hand and just let it slide along the length of the leg. And remember how we did that side stretch on the beginning of the class? You can just let your left hand kind of slide up the side of your body, letting your elbow kind of reach up. And if it feels okay for you to sweep your arm alongside your ear, you can do that. And we're still more or less keeping our gaze forward. And now we're going to turn to look to that right leg. Slowly let your ribs turn. Let your left hand come down. Let your right hand come down to either side of the leg. Inhale here, a little bit of a lift up through the heart. Exhale, can you reach your heart a little closer towards your right foot? We're not trying to fold the body completely over. And just notice if your toes are still pointing upwards. And then use your hands to help walk back towards your body to help lift you up. And then facing center again. You can place your left hand onto your left leg and just let it slide down the length of your leg. You're still gazing forward. Let your right hand come to your right hip and just let it slide up the side of your ribs. Let the elbow do the pulling. Yeah, we're going to have a curve into the side of the body. You can stay like this, or you can feel free to drape that right arm over the ear. And the next breath, we'll start to look towards that left leg. Allow the right hand to land to the ground, the left hand to the other side of the leg. Take an inhale, get that little bit of an upward lift through the heart. And then an exhale, reach your heart towards your toes. Nice. And then use your hands now to walk back towards your torso and then help push you up. Beautiful. Take your hands to the inside of the knees, and then you're going to lift your knees up, pull your feet in. We'll put the feet on the floor, and then I'm just going to turn around to that short end of my mat again. I'm going to take my right leg straight out. You can bring your left knee in a little closer. Going to take a twist here. Let your left hand come behind you. And then we're going to lean back a bit here. Give yourself plenty of space between your torso and your left knee. And then you can go ahead and start to twist a little bit towards that left side. you will find that you can reach your right arm maybe to the outside of that left knee. And then from here, maybe you can come a little upright with your torso. You can bend your right elbow and place your right hand on your left shoulder, gazing back, finding your twist. And then release your twist, looking straight ahead. Let both of your legs go straight out. Bring your right knee in, take your right hand behind you. Lean back as much as you want to. Take that little bit of a twist with your shoulders towards that right side. You can start to place your left arm to the outside of that right knee. And then you can use a little bit of a push into your right hand to help bring you into an upright position. And then you can bend your left hand to place your left hand on your right shoulder and gaze backwards. And then we're going to start to take our gaze forward and then undo your twist, gazing forward, and then both legs straight ahead. And then let's just put a little bend into the knees, and then you're going to lift your hips up and shift them back a little bit behind you. So keep that bend in the knees. Can you see if you can get a little bit of a forward movement with your hips moving towards the direction of your knees? And then from here, you can slide your arms along the length of your legs, and then you can start to straighten your legs as much as you want. And we're just having a little bit of a reaching forward. Again, we don't have to fold completely over. However, if that is available for you, feel free to do that. Can you allow your ribs to rest on your thighs? You can put your hands to the mat, or your legs, or your toes. Let's breathe here. Take one more breath. And then hands to the mat. Start to walk your hands towards you to lift you upright again. And then we're just going to shift the hips towards the heels. Come down to the elbows. We're going to come down for a final rest position. So nice and slow, bringing the head down. Now, if you prefer constructive rest, you're going to just keep your feet on the floor with the knees bent. You can take your feet nice and wide here. You can let your knees tap on towards each other. If you prefer to take your legs straight, go ahead, do that. And then whatever position you found, get yourself as comfortable as you possibly can. You can close your eyes or just keep your gaze soft. Be here for 1 minute. Now we're going to slowly transition. Start to notice your breath. If you would like to stay here in your final resting pose, please feel free to do that. It would be nice if you could spend 5 minutes or so here. But if you need to get on with your day, let's go ahead and start to make some little wiggles with the fingers and the toes. And then this whole closing sequence, you can even keep your eyes closed to just move really slow. Put one foot on the floor and then the other. Get comfortable in your spine. And then bring one knee into the chest and then the other. Give yourself a hug. Perhaps rock your hips a little side to side. And then go ahead and roll over to one side and then just pause there. Let your top hand land to the ground. And then use that hand now to push yourself up. You can be really heavy through the head again. And then find yourself back into a comfortable seated position just as we started. Place your hands onto your thighs, lifting up through your heart. Gaze slightly forward, or eyes can stay closed. And then the next inhale, the palms turn upwards. Exhale, the hands come together in front of the heart. Inhale, bow your head towards your heart to close off your practice. And then next breath, lift your gaze. Namaste.